Tesla is not expanding an insurance business. What Tesla is really doing right now is far more important. They are quietly building the rules for how humans and AI will be evaluated in society. And this single move connects directly to full self-driving robotaxis and Tesla's long-term value as a company. Hi, this is Ken. In this video, I want to help you see something most headlines completely miss. If you are a Tesla owner, this affects how your car will be treated in the future. If you are a Tesla investor, this affects how Tesla scales trust, responsibility, and profit in an AI-driven world. This is not about short-term stock price moves. This is about how Tesla is positioning itself as a rule maker, not just a product maker. Let's start with the facts. Tesla Insurance has officially launched in Florida after nearly 3 years of regulatory adjustments. Florida is one of the most expensive auto insurance markets in the United States, driven by high accident rates, natural disasters, and legal risk. At the same time, Tesla is preparing a new feature inside the app. Drivers will be able to dispute or appeal their safety score when they believe it was calculated incorrectly. On the surface, this looks simple. Insurance expansion, customer support improvement, but the real meaning sits much deeper than that. Tesla Insurance is built on real-time driving data. Hard braking, sharp turns, following distance, speed, and situational awareness are all measured continuously. Your monthly insurance premium changes based on how you actually drive, not who you are on paper. Now, here's the key point. Tesla is voluntarily allowing users to challenge its own algorithm. That sounds small, but from a system design perspective, this is a very deliberate move. Tesla is transforming safety score from an experimental metric into a social system that must be explainable, accountable, and trusted at scale. Tesla does not build isolated products. Everything connects back to data, learning loops, and scale. Allowing disputes means Tesla is training a feedback loop where AI evaluates humans and humans correct AI. This is exactly how Tesla trains full self-driving, not in a closed lab, but in the real world, under real conditions, with real consequences. Insurance is simply the safest place to practice this relationship before autonomy becomes widespread. From an investor's perspective, this is not about insurance margins. This is about ownership of risk data. Whoever controls how risk is measured controls pricing, liability, and regulation. Traditional insurers rely on static data. Tesla operates on live behavioral data. That difference is not incremental, it is structural. Tesla is building an AI-driven financial layer that sits on top of mobility, energy, and autonomy. Here is the surprising part. By allowing safety score appeals, Tesla is not weakening its system. It is strengthening it. Most AI systems fail, not because they are wrong, but because people do not trust them. Tesla is solving trust before it becomes a legal and social crisis. This is rare. Most companies wait for regulation to force them to act. Tesla is proactively designing accountability into the system. That matters enormously for robotaxis. When robotaxis become real, the biggest question will not be technology, it will be responsibility. Who is at fault when something goes wrong? The human, the AI, or the system itself? Safety score is training Tesla to separate human decisions from AI decisions using data that can be reviewed, challenged, and improved. Tesla Insurance is effectively the rehearsal stage for robotaxi economics. If Tesla can prove accountability at the insurance level, scaling autonomy becomes far easier. This news was never about insurance. It was about Tesla practicing how AI and humans coexist under shared responsibility. Long-term value is created by companies that define rules, not just sell products. Tesla is quietly positioning itself as the company that defines how AI risk is measured in the real world. That is why Tesla continues to look misunderstood in the short term and powerful in the long term. So here's the question I'll leave you with. How comfortable are you with being evaluated by AI if you also have the right to challenge it? If this perspective helped you see Tesla differently, feel free to like the video. And if you want daily analysis that connects today's news to tomorrow's reality, consider subscribing. As long-term investors, we don't chase noise. We watch the systems being built beneath the surface. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Before we wrap up, let me take a moment to introduce myself. I drive a Tesla Model Y, and at home, I've installed a Tesla Powerwall, so I actually charge my car with solar energy. I truly believe Tesla is shaping the future, and that's why I share the latest news and insights here on this channel. I'm from Japan, but I want to connect with Tesla fans all around the world. That's why I also create an English version of my videos. YouTube now lets you switch the audio into your own language, so you can enjoy it in whatever language you prefer. Most of all, I'd love to connect with Tesla fans everywhere so we can support Tesla together. I also share updates on X, so feel free to follow me there and let's connect. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.